Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. Last week I posted a video talking about my skincare favorites and the products I highly recommend and I love. So this week I was thinking to do a regrets or products which did not work for me kind of video, but then I'm always on the internet searching for new products and they're like, I check ingredients, I'm like, nah, I'm not gonna buy this, because I thoroughly go through ingredients before I buy any product. Only if I'm okay with the ingredients which are there in the product, then only I apply on my face. And even sometimes, even if the ingredients are really great, sometimes few products end up not working. So it depends on, like, you know, skin to skin, that's very common. So I'm always constantly on a hunt. So like, I thought I got this idea of doing an anti haul. Just a very big disclaimer before, you know, getting into the products, if you have these products and they work for you, absolutely fine, but these are something I would never purchase or never use because I'm very picky when it comes to ingredients and not a lot of things suit my face. If they work for you, completely fine. And just for, you know, knowledge, I have combination leaning oily skin and acne prone and sensitive skin. So yeah, let's get into the video and see what I would not buy. So the first product I have, actually the first two, like I have two products from Nykaa which I like don't like. Most of this Nykaa skincare, it doesn't like catch my eye or it doesn't seem like a very genuine product which would help my skin. So I never really, like, you know, showed so much interest in Nykaa skincare. And so the two products I have right here are the Go For Glow Peel Off Mask and the Rose Gold Oil. So peel off mask, not a big fan, like no matter what type of peel off mask, I really don't like it. And second one is the Rose Gold Oil. I'm a person little who's kind of away from facial oils because there is a certain, like, that explanation is for a different time. For oily skin, I don't really like facial oils. The main problem I have with Nykaa is they don't disclose their complete ingredient list on their website. So that kind of puts me off because I really like to know ingredients. They just have key ingredients. And like, even if they just have key ingredients and you don't have the entire list, you don't know where the key ingredients are placed. Like, if the key ingredients are on the last line of the ingredient list, then like they wouldn't, you know, give any effect for your skin as well. So you don't get to know the ingredient list unless you have the product in your hand, which is not, like, you know, ideal for me. And I think that's kind of shady for a brand to do, because normally when there are other brands, like, you know, let's say Maybelline, Mamaearth, like such brands, and if you don't have the ingredient list on Nykaa, you can definitely go to their original website of the brand and you will definitely have the ingredient list with like of each and every product. But Nykaa is the main website for Nykaa products and they don't have the ingredient list on their website, so that puts me off. So that's the reason I've never tried Nykaa. So two, I think they do have a lot of fragrance in their products, and three is I think they mostly, you know, make products in a selling point, like, you know, what would look appealing for the, you know, public and that sort, and not so much into the ingredients, according to my opinion. That is for the Nykaa. Like, I just you know, came across these two products recently, so I'm just, you know, mentioning these two. Nykaa does have like good makeup products. I love their highlighter, I like their foundation, I love their lipsticks, but skincare, not so much. The second one is from Coco Soul Face Scrub with Virgin Coconut Oil. If you know me at all, I hate coconut oil. Coconut oil is the worst facial oil, like, is worst oil, period. Like, it's really good for intake, but it's highly comedogenic. It's my worst nightmare. So Coco Soul Face Scrub, like, not only this product, they do have the entire range of coconut oil, which I am like, anybody who has acne should stay away from it. Anybody who don't have acne also should stay away from it, because it might clog your pores and get you acne. You never know. People who can take coconut oil on their skin have the most resilient skin ever. They're like blessed. They just, period, just have good skin. So that's the reason coconut oil is suiting for them. Or else, like, coconut oil is like really comedogenic. I would never apply it on my face, and I would never ever recommend anybody to apply coconut oil on their face. So recently I've been on a hunt for like a really good hyaluronic acid which is like available in India. So I asked you guys, you know, recommendation, and a lot of you recommended It Skin. So like, I got curious about it and checked it, and you know what, it's like literally not even hyaluronic acid. I don't know how, what hydration it gives for your skin. because the hyaluronic acid, like the sodium hyaluronate, is literally below fragrance, so low on the list. So I would not really call hyaluronic acid. And if I am using hyaluronic acid, or if I want a product which has hyaluronic acid, I want it to be at least in like the first 5 ingredients of the product. Like I want it to be, you know, in a high concentration, or I want to know how much hyaluronic acid is there in that. And this is just like, you know, it's right below. Don't know how it would help hydrate my skin in any way. Hi guys, so I'm in between editing and I was like, you know, trying to get screenshots of, you know, ingredients, etc. And what I found interesting about this serum is like, when I see the ingredients of the serum on Nykaa's website, it just says 3 ingredients, like hyaluronic acid, some extract, agar. So I went on online, like on Google, and checked. So like I got the certain ingredient list which I was talking about, and one of the images even my followers sent, I checked that and I cross-checked it. But now when I'm going to, like, you know, get a proper screenshot of the product, it again says that sodium hyaluronate was on like the top, like the second or third ingredient. You check the reviews in that, and you know, there is like somebody saying that, you know, this is not hyaluronic acid, so like it is really low on the list and everything of that sort. But again, if I check other websites, again sodium hyaluronate is on top. So I don't know what is going on here. Maybe like they reformulated the product or something of that sort, because like few people have the, you know, ingredient list where sodium hyaluronate is really, really low, and few people have it like really, really high. So I don't know what is going on here, but I just, like, you know, went with what I saw online previously and what my followers sent me a picture for. So yeah, just wanted to give you a heads up. So the next one is L'Oreal Revital Lift Crystal Micro Essence. Yes, this has been such a hype product recently, and like I've even been contacted for the campaign, but I didn't do it because I checked the ingredient list of the campaign, and guess what, it contains alcohol, and alcohol is one of the ingredients I kind of stay away from. And even if I, like, you know, have to ignore it, it has to be like on like really low on the list, like maybe like the last second line or the first, like, you know, last line. But this is literally the third ingredient of this is you know, alcohol. So I don't know how it would benefit me in any way, and it does have, you know, perfume and fragrance quite, like, you know, on the list. L'Oreal has amazing makeup, but I don't know, its skincare never, like, you know, caught my eye so much. I used to use their clay masks, you know, a while back. They were okay, they were not that great, but they were like good products here and there. So next I have two products from Face Shop, and Face Shop is a brand which, like, okay 50% good, 50% bad. Like the main problem I have with the brand is they're quite, like, you know, they do have like a lot of fragrance in their skincare, but there are really good products in Face Shop as well. Just need to be mindful of which you choose and pick. So there are two products which, like, you know, caught my eye recently. One is the Face Shop Jeju, I think that is how you pronounce, Jeju Volcanic Lava Cleansing Foam, and the other one is the Rice and Ceramide Moisturizing Cream. So I've actually, like, you know, had this opinion about the Jeju Volcanic Lava Cleansing Foam like a long time ago, because I was searching for really good cleansers, and this is the one I would never ever pick. So why I would not try this face wash is it has a lot of oils. It has like orange oil, lemon peel oil, lavender oil, like so many oils in a cleanser, and I don't think that it's ideal for me. Like, I don't really like so many oils. I just want a gentle cleanser, like the one I told you, you know, in my previous video, like the simple cleanser, the organic harvest cleanser. So, you know, this is not for me, and it does have like SLS in it, and it does have perfume, again, alcohol denat. Like, so, you know, these are kind of products which I would avoid. So this face wash is not for me. For the Rice and Ceramide Moisturizer, the thing is, when you, you know, have an entire range of product, I would like imagine or think that, you know, the ingredient which you're, you know, marketing for, you know, has to be high on the list. So the Rice and Ceramide cream has ceramide in like the last, like literally what, third, second line. It has ton of ingredients above it, and the ceramide is right below it. And so I don't know how that would benefit in any way. It's just like would be a normal moisturizer with a tiny bit of ceramide here and there. And so like for me, that was a problem. You know, like if I'm buying something for ceramide, I need literally a lot of ceramides in it. So this is like kind of a cheat for me because it has so low ceramides in it, if you understand my point. But Face Shop has really good products, like the cleansing oil I mentioned before. It does have one cleanser which I really like. I forgot, I'll mention like, you know, in the caption or anywhere. That is really good. So there are like, you know, pick and choose products here and there which you would like, you know, which would be ideal. Don't just blindly buy any products because somebody's telling it's good or somebody's claiming that this is there in that. Just see where, you know, the key ingredients they're telling lie in it. If somebody's claiming to have like hyaluronic acid in their skincare, then go and see where is the sodium hyaluronate in the entire list. It's like in the bottom, then there's no use because they have little tiny amount of hyaluronic acid in it. So next we have Mamaearth Uptan face wash with turmeric and saffron for tan removal. So you guys know I really like Mamaearth. I love their moisturizer, the apple cider, oil-free apple cider vinegar moisturizer. They do have a lot of amazing products. They do have really good ingredients in their products. You know, it's one of the really good skincare brands in India. But this is one face wash I would not use because it does have coconut oil in it. So again, coconut oil, not my jam. There are a couple of products which are going to come also. Like the coconut oil is my issue with it. So this product, not for me. So then we have one more Indian skincare brand, which is Pure by Priyanka. And I have a problem with their sunscreen because, like, you know, having coconut oil in the face wash or a scrub and then you try to wash off is like a different level, and having coconut oil in a sunscreen is on a different level. So I was really excited like for by the brand because I do enjoy, you know, that brand really well. I like the honey face wash, but you know, so I was trying, actually I was hunting like for really good sunscreens these days. So I heard that, you know, this sunscreen is good, so I went to check the ingredient list. And the second ingredient is coconut oil. It just blew my mind because, you know, these are brands all like, you know, coming up. All the Indian skincare brands are really trying to make and, you know, good products with like great ingredients, and, you know, they're being mindful of such things. So I don't know why, like, because sunscreen is already a very heavy thing and having coconut oil in it, not my jam. Like, other ingredients of the sunscreen are quite like, you know, okay and good, but the second ingredient is coconut oil, so I would never ever apply that on my face whatsoever. So then we have the famous Body Shop Tea Tree Anti Imperfection Daily Solution. If I could, like, you know, earn a penny every time somebody asks if they can use this. This is the product even I've, like, you know, heard a lot when I was trying to, you know, figure out something for my acne. But I'm not going to say anything, just let's look at the ingredient list once, okay? The first ingredient is water. Very nice, a common ingredient to have. Most of the products have water. Second is alcohol denat. Like, literally denatured alcohol is the second ingredient. And, like, people who suffer with acne usually have very compromised skin barrier, and putting things like fragrance, alcohol and all these things do like irritate it more than cause more acne. That's the reason certain ingredients are told to be avoided, because the skin barrier is already really compromised. So things like alcohol make it very, very worse. And I don't know how people like it. Like, even if, like, you know, for time being, it kind of maybe reduces your oil and, you know, helps you get rid of acne in some way because it kind of dries your acne. I don't really think it will help you in a long run to, you know, help repair your skin barrier, because unless your skin barrier is repaired, like, you are going to eventually break out again and again and again. And if people have dry skin and they suffer with acne and they want to go with this, they'll just like die with dry skin because alcohol just brings down and dries down your face like too much. So this product I would not recommend at all. Like, I don't know if it works for you, it works for you. But so it does have like a lot of fragrant ingredients as well. Like, it literally tells on their website, they have like lemonine, citral, citronelle, blah, blah, blah. Like, it literally has like a whole list of fragrant ingredients. I don't understand how that would help a acne prone skin person whose skin barrier is like already damaged, and like you are adding more fragrance to it. Literally, other than tea tree oil, there's nothing good in this oil. So next, what we have, next and last, what we have is the ENN/overnight acne treatment. So they do have like really amazing products for hair, but this product, first of all, they claimed it to be for an acne treatment, and the second ingredient on their list is coconut oil, and the third and the fourth ingredient is like lavender oil. So coconut oil, extremely comedogenic. Lavender oil can be a little irritating. Few people consider it calm, few people consider it irritant. So, you know, there's always a debate about, you know, lavender oil. But yeah, like, maybe even if I'm trying to ignore lavender oil, there's coconut oil in this, which I would never use. If they removed coconut oil out of the product, I would definitely use it because it does have tamanu oil, but tamanu oil is like really low on the list. It's like the last ingredient in the list. So if you don't know, tamanu oil is quite good, you know, to get rid of the blemishes on your skin or anything of that sort. But coconut oil, not my jam again. I try to kind of keep the video, you know, in the same league with the same ingredients, ki why I would not buy certain products, so that, you know, it would not be like extremely confusing for you. So if you like this video and if you want me to do more such videos and, like, you know, anti hauls and anything of that sort, then make sure you like the video so that I know that, you know, you want me to do more such videos. And yeah, that's it for today's video. If you liked it, make sure you like, share, comment, subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell so that you get notified every time I post. It'll mean the world to me, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. Come on.